Let's look at the different options for creating a new drawing in Creo Parametric. It helps if you have the part or assembly open that you want to start detailing. To start the new drawing, I'll click on the new icon, or you could use the keyboard shortcut of Control N. And for the type, I'll change to drawing. Then you can fill in the file name and the common name. There is a checkbox for use default template. For the first option that I'm going to show you, I'm going to uncheck this option. And then click the OK button. Now this brings open the new drawing dialog box. Up at the top, it lists the default model, in other words, whichever part or assembly that was active before you started the drawing. Then underneath specify template, there are three options. And since I unchecked use default template, the radio button for empty is selected. And that's the first option that I'm going to show you. For an empty drawing, you can specify the orientation, either portrait or landscape. And when you do so, you have a drop-down list where you can choose some common sheet sizes. If you want a different size than one that is listed, you could click on the variable button and then choose either inches or millimeters and specify the width and the height. But I'm going to start off with landscape and B size, then click OK. And my drawing is created, and all that you see is an outline for the size of the sheet. To create my first view, I can hold down the right mouse button and use General View. I will not use a combined state, and then locate my view on the drawing sheet. In the Drawing View Properties dialog box, I can start off with the front view. You can use the repaint icon to update the drawing screen and click OK, and my drawing view is created. Now let's take a look at the second option. And so for my second option for creating a drawing, let's go back to the part model. Then I'll click the new icon again, change to drawing, and click OK. Here I have my default model at the top again. Since I left use default template checked, it automatically selects the radio button for use template, but I'm going to show you the second option, empty with format. And so, empty with format allows me to use the browse button to select different drawing formats that I have available. The directory that is listed in here is based on the configuration option pro_format_dir. I'll click open out of here and then OK. Now it asks me for which sheet I want to use. I will use sheet one of my format. And so my drawing is started out, and what this format gives me is some graphics around the sheet border for my zones. Also, I have a title block in the lower right-hand corner with some information that's automatically filled in, and a revision block in the upper right corner. So, just like before, I could go ahead and start creating new drawing views on here now. For the third option, again, I will hop back to my part model and use the new icon for creating a drawing. Click the OK button, and this time I'm going to use the template option. And with a template, you can select a different drawing template that you want to use. In this case, I'll use my part template. The templates that are listed in here are based off of the configuration option start_model_directory. Which template is used by default is based on the configuration option template_drawing. So I will click OK, and my drawing is created. And with a template, what it does is it grabs a format just like before, and automatically places some views on my drawing sheet, as well as some of the dimensions. And I can select on the different drawing views and move them out so that there's a little more clarity in here. And so it starts off with a front view and two projection views and throws the different dimensions on here. I'll show you an example of starting off an assembly with a template. So here I have an engine assembly. Let's click on the new button, change to drawing, click OK, and I'm using my assembly template, click OK. And my assembly template starts off the drawing, places three views, including a larger ISO exploded view on the drawing sheet. So those are the three different options for starting off a new drawing. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this video.